This is a Swede Speaks.
It is time to talk about this week in Sweden. So, let's get started with that. On Friday, April 20th, 2018, in Västerås, in the province of Västmanland, about 67 miles to the west of Stockholm, a 21-year-old man who has been detained under suspicion of opening fire towards a policeman's house in Västerås was not charged for attempted murder. According to the attorney, the man should still be detained, suspected of other crimes, including severe possession of weapons and severe narcotics crimes. The detainment decision on these charges are upheld. Ardalan Shekarabi, Sweden's Minister for Public Administration and a Social Democrat, wrote a debate article in the mainstream media outlet Aftonbladet, in which article he said that, quote, "The Sweden Democrats threaten our Swedish values," close quote. The Swedish general election will be held on September 9th, and I think we can tell that by the news recently. Which brings us to our next story. The moderate coalition party, Sweden's pseudo-conservatives, proposed a national ban on begging. The Sweden Democrats proposed this already 7 years ago, and so far, the moderates have voted against banning begging every time it has been proposed in the Swedish parliament. In the neighborhood of Fröslunda, in Eskilstuna, in Södermanland, about 67 miles west of Stockholm, it was reported that the staff at Tallåsen preschool are stressed to the point of breakdown. The kids at the preschool are shouting, "F you," and they are biting, kicking, and hitting the staff. This is described in a letter that the staff wrote to local politicians. Only two of the kids at the preschool are native Swedish speakers. In Vaksala, in the city of Uppsala, in Uppland, north of Stockholm, a gang consisting of so-called unaccompanied migrants attacked two boys, roughly 17 years old. The gang were unable to rob the boys, since at least one of them is physically fit and tough, according to the boy's father. On Saturday, April 21st, according to a poll from the market research company Ipsos, 41% of the Swedes want considerably less so-called refugees. That is twice as many as 3 years ago. 60% of the Swedes want less so-called refugees, and 41% want considerably less. At the same time, 12% want more refugees, as compared to 26% in 2015. On Färingsö, in Uppland, to the west of Stockholm, weapons and hand grenades were found on a small island of Färingsö, which led to a large police effort. The bomb squad participated in the effort. In an interview with Sveriges Radio, which roughly could be translated as Sweden's radio, moderate coalition party leader Ulf Kristersson said that the alliance parties, well, that is, the moderate coalition party, the liberal party, the Christian Democrats, and the center party, lack a common line when it comes to migration policies, but that after the election in September this year, they all want to negotiate with the Social Democrats. Ulf Kristersson also said that he will not cooperate with the Sweden Democrats. On Sunday, April 22nd, in an interview with the Christian newspaper Världen Idag, Ebba Busch Thor, the leader of the Christian Democrats, said that the best thing for a child is to grow up with a father and a mother. She recently said to the gay paper QX that a gay couple can be just as good parents as she and her husband can. To Världen Idag, she said that her point was that parenting abilities are not related to sexual orientation, but that it is in the child's best interest to grow up in a nuclear family. In Helsingborg, in Skåne, in the south of Sweden, during Sunday afternoon, a fight between two people started on the street of Hantverkaregatan. One of the persons involved had an axe. The police were unable to find the fighters, but they found an axe a few blocks away. Åsa Emanuelsson at the police control center said that, quote, "Nobody is arrested for anything and nobody is hurt," close quote. On Monday, April 23rd, according to a poll from Novus, the support for the Social Democrats is record low. 26.9% support the Social Democrats. In the 2014 general election, the Social Democrats got 31% of the votes. The government parties and the left party have a combined support of 39%. The Alliance parties are supported by 36.3%. The Sweden Democrats have a support of 18.2% compared to 12.9% in the 2014 election. The upcoming election in Sweden will be an interesting one. In the neighborhood of Tynnered in Gothenburg, school personnel at Vetnedalskolan said that so-called everyday honor is increasing among school children as young as 7 years old. Helena Kollberg, principal at Vetnedalskolan, says that some kids check on each other to make sure that they eat the right things and associate with the right people. She also says that in some cases, when there has been a conflict between two kids, one of them fetched an older brother or cousin to beat the other kid. After that, incidents like that have been used as a threat. The principal says that even though the school has spoken to parents, they are unable to get through to them. In Skärholmen in Stockholm, Monday morning at 4 a.m., police were called to an address in Skärholmen. A man in his 70s was attacking a woman in the same age with a knife. The police shot the man. The man and the woman had a relationship, and they were both brought to hospital with injuries. At 6 a.m., it was reported that the man had died. In Helsingborg, in Skåne, in the south of Sweden, it was reported that the number of library staff wearing personal alarms have increased. Alarms are used to call on colleagues, but also to call for security guards. On Tuesday, April 24th, at a press conference, Ylva Johansson, Sweden's Minister for Employment and a Social Democrat, announced that the Social Democrats want to introduce a language duty, meaning that newly arrived migrants who do not participate in Swedish language classes will lose their benefits. As I said, there is an election coming up in Sweden, and this shows in the rhetoric from both the Social Democrats and the Moderates. In Södertälje, in Södermanland, southwest of Stockholm, Södertälje municipality is one of many municipalities that have been given dispensation to be allowed to have security guards in the town center. These security guards are hired since police efforts are not enough. 54 municipalities in Sweden hire security guards to fill in for the police. On Wednesday, April 25th, in Copenhagen, in Denmark, the Danish inventor Peter Madsen was sentenced to life in jail over the murder of the Swedish freelance journalist Kim Wall. The Swedish parliament decided that people who cause disturbances, including threatening personnel, will be easier to send away from hospitals. The motion proposing this came from the Christian Democrats. In the neighborhood of Angered, in Gothenburg, police were called to Angered Square Wednesday afternoon after three persons had been playing with a gun. Two men in their 20s were taken in for questioning, suspected of gun crime. Thomas Fuchsberg, police press spokesperson, underlined that the police did not yet know whether it was a real weapon. And on Thursday, April 26, in Albyberget, in Botkyrka municipality, to the southwest of Stockholm, at 2 a.m., police were called after a woman, roughly 18 years old, fell from a balcony on the third floor. A man in his 30s was arrested, suspected of having pushed her off the balcony. The woman was brought to hospital, but died from her injuries. In Sundbyberg, in Uppland, to the north of Stockholm, during Thursday evening, a woman was stabbed to death in an apartment. A man is arrested, suspected of murder. Annika Strandhäll, Sweden's Minister for Social Affairs and a Social Democrat, said that the problems of Swedish healthcare are not because of refugees, but because of the growing number of older people. As I have mentioned before, Sweden has among the longest healthcare lines in Europe. Sweden also has among the highest number of people per hospital bed. Those were some of the stories that came out of Sweden this week, from Friday until Thursday. As you probably understand, I had to choose some stories over other stories. Otherwise, this video would be way long. So that's what I have to say about this, right now. I would like to thank all the people who support my work. And if you like what I do, if you think what I do is important, please consider sending me a dollar or two, or 10, or 100. That's always greatly appreciated. Also, check out my live stream tomorrow, Saturday, at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 2 p.m. Mountain Time, 3 p.m. Central Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Time, 9 p.m. Western European Time, 10 p.m. Central European Time, 11 p.m. Eastern European Time, and midnight further Eastern European time. In my live stream, I discuss current events in Sweden, the Nordic countries, and the world. So, check out that tomorrow. Until next time, have a nice day, and God bless.